Hello again, everyone. I have not done one of these in a while, but I was recently quote-unquote called out for lazily making sigils as if I'm using like some kind of fucking generator, which I'm not, obviously. But I'm just like, you know, I haven't done a video in a while, and sure, why not? Let's just do a quickie here for funsies. Gotta change my keyboard layout. So today I'm just gonna make another one of my 555 Gematria sigils, because I've been kind of obsessed. Stop grabbing the fucking ellipse, dude. Jesus Christ. I've been kind of obsessed with the number 555 for Gematria reasons. And I guess a big part of why is because the gematria of Lilith and Lucifer in Hebrew, Lilith is 480 and Lucifer is 75 if you use the name that appears in that famous Bible verse, the son of the morning star, Helel ben Shachar, but Helel or Helel is, that adds up to 75. But yeah, 480 plus 75 equals 555, and I've kind of been integrating that into my identity lately, because it's kind of a nice number, honestly. Anyway, I'm getting distracted as to what I'm trying to do here. So, the sigil du jour is Baphomet themed, as I mentioned, and it just means Baphomet is a riddle, which is actually really fucking appropriate, because Baphomet's kind of a mysterious, sort of shadowy figure, and their imagery has been used for all sorts of things throughout history. And I mean, the most familiar thing about Baphomet to most people is the, dude, what the fuck? These layers are being arranged oddly. What was I saying? Oh yeah, so Baphomet is, and I'm gonna be turning my head to align these fucking letters, because I always do that, and since I'm on camera, you can see that I'm not using any sort of fancy positioning stuff, aside from kind of just eyeballing, and, well, okay, this app has, like, grid system in place, so I use that a lot. It's helpful, but there's definitely no push this button to make a sigil. Because people keep assuming that, because, I don't know, I guess, like, my sigils just look so geometrically symmetric that people assume that I use some kind of quick generator tool, because, you know, I couldn't possibly do this with my own, I don't know, intuitive, artistic, whatever. I have a hard time seeing myself as an artist, because this, even though I'm not using a generator tool, my process is very, very algorithmic, and, oh shit, I'm a dumbass, I just forgot, this needs to be 9-pointed star, because there's 9 fucking letters. Hold Control Z until I fix my mistake. There we go. I've gotten pretty good at the positioning the letters around the circle, though, and I use the star to help me be like, okay, this is where the letter is supposed to go to maintain symmetry. Why is the letter looks like it's being cut off by the, oh, whatever. The star looks extra weird today for some reason, and I can't figure out why. The points there just don't look right. Yeah, what? Why? This ellipse is doing some weird shit with the borders. You see that? Anyway, wow, I'm, like, meandering all over the place. I was trying to talk about Baphomet's historical stuffs. Cause if you look at the wiki page, you'll see mention of the Knights Templar and all that fun stuff. And the historical record suggests that those accusations were, to a large degree, politically motivated, because powerful people in the 1300s were like, I want the money that these Templar people have. It must have been, I think it was a pope who who, like, wanted money. I forget. I read about this stuff not super long ago, but my memory is failing me right now. But, so there's a nice Templar thing, and obviously you can look that up if you're curious. The wiki page is actually pretty good. And there's also Eliphas Levy, who did the whole hermetic kind of imagery of Baphomet that a lot of people are familiar with, where, you know, you've got Baphomet doing left arm pointing down, and I forget how exactly the hand motions are, but and I have Baphomet tattoos on my arms. Hebrew translations of Sylvain Coagula, which are the words that appear on the Eliphas Levy artwork. But that artwork is popular and famous, especially in, like, Western occultism, because it kind of compresses a lot of important concepts of, like, spiritual alchemy and stuff. Like, Sylvain Coagula, a reference to alchemy, because you've got Sylvain, which means dissolve, and Coagula, which, like, means coagulate. So, like, there's a separation and crystallization process involved in alchemy, and people can kind of take that concept and run with it, because it just applies to a lot of things. There's a very strong duality inherent there. And I also need to steal colors for this sigil, because there's another one I did recently. I just want to grab that brown. I like that brown color. And I can never... Dude, what the fuck? Where's the damn ellipse? What's going on here? This app did some funky shit recently. I don't even know. My layers are all fucked up. The ordering of everything seems off. Anyway, I just wanted to steal a brown. If I could just close it, that'd be nice. That'd make the ellipses brown. Anyway, yeah, I was talking about... What was I talking about? I was talking about alchemy and the Baphomet artwork, I think. But... Where was that? God, I don't even know where I was going with this. My brain is all over the place right now. maybe I should, like, shut up for a second so I can focus on making this sigil, because I'm just, like, talking out my ass right now. okay, let's... Oh, I guess I should explain. So, I recently changed my method to include using two fonts simultaneously. These are both Hebrew, but this is a font that I paid money for called Shemesh, which means sun in Hebrew. But it's kind of like a nice handwriting-ish font. Like, it for some reason, handwriting in Hebrew looks very different from the block print, and this kind of captures what's fairly common in terms of how people actually write Hebrew by hand. As much as I like the block letters, it's a little bit boxy and kind of, it gets geometrically boring after a while, and so I kind of realized that if I use both the block font and the handwritten font, it kind of adds more variety of shape. This one has a lot more curves, and it's just generally prettier. And I tried doing stuff just with the cursive one, but that also got a bit stale, so I get bored of stuff pretty easily, and I like to switch things up every once in a while. So this combo of using both fonts with the same phrase has been working out really well for me, actually. And because of that, I want to keep going with that. Anyway, so, right, Baphomet is a riddle. This is Baphomet, one of the spellings. There's actually two different possible spellings for Baphomet, which I find interesting. This is the one that people who looked into the name and tried to find clever cryptographic meanings with it tend to use. It uses the Tav as the last letter, because if you do the Atbash, or the cipher where you basically take... Well, actually, the name Atbash is kind of the definition of the cipher, right? You've got Aleph equals Tav, because Aleph is the first letter and Tav is the last, and then Bet equals Sheen, Bet being the second letter, and Sheen being the second to last letter, and so on. But if you take the at-bash of Baphomet as spelled like this, you get Sophia, well, a strange spelling of Sophia, because it uses Sheen, which can be used as the letter Sin without the, you know, sh sound, but it's not always, it's not a super common thing, I would say. Sin doesn't appear a ton in my experience. Usually you have Samek if you want like a s sound, but it's Sophia spelled with a Sin, which is odd. Pe and Vav are their own inverses, so this becomes Vav and this becomes Pe, and then Mem is inverse of Yod, and then Tav is Aleph. The other spelling of Baphomet uses a Tet instead of a Tav, which is the other T sound you can have in Hebrew. I know, like, historically people have used Tav to make, like, a TH sound, like, you know, Baphomet, I guess, but modern Hebrew doesn't do that, and as I am mostly a student of modern Hebrew, I kind of go with modern Hebrew pronunciation. I guess also Ashkenazi Jews pronounce final Tav as like an S sound, so it would be like Baphomet, but because you can have like a dot inside, I forget what it's called, but the dot makes it actually a hard T sound. But I am getting way off topic here, because I've been talking and haven't been actually sigilizing anything. I made the copy as a backup in case I fuck up. I always do that, that's part of my process. Okay, and then we've got all the letters separated out. Alright. Then save the progress. And then I just start kind of fucking around with the letters, as my intuition draws me to do. Just sort of play with them, put them together, and I tend to be a bit of a pixel perfect. I like the horizontal lines to match up nicely, otherwise I get all pissy about it. And especially here with these mixed fonts, it gets a little dicey. Insert interesting commentary here. Yeah, my brain is apparently just not in the mood to be braining right now. I don't think I got quite enough sleep last night, because I stayed up late and I'm doing the whole take a break from the marijuanas thing again. Took a month-long break and then tried some Delta-8 THC, which is technically legal in a lot of places, including my state, so hooray for doing the legal thing. But I sort of discovered that I kind of have the same problems with it as regular THC-9, so I'm like, yeah, it kind of fucks with my sleep and fucks with my motivation during the day, so I'm kind of just gonna... That's gonna take a hiatus and really try to just avoid the everyday smoking habit. Well, vaping habit. I actually have a pretty decent vape. I bought from a local store. Okay. I hope this turns out okay. Right now, I'm clearly having some marked difficulties with multitasking because, as mentioned, I am not at full capacity mentally right now, as it turns out. I woke up very groggy and the situation hasn't super improved since then. what can you do? Let's see here. I like my process because it's very intuitive and I kind of just put stuff wherever and it seems to work out well a lot of the time, so, you know, why fuck with a process if it's working, right? Let's see. The key for me also is to try to not overthink too much where I put stuff because honestly the positioning is kind of arbitrary. The more important part to me is the allowing my intuition to do its thing, because that's where creative power comes from, I think, and if you start second guessing yourself too much, it can kind of get in the way of getting those creative juices flowing. And, you know, my critics are going to be like, but you're not thinking about where you're putting every line. And I'm just like, well, my conscious mind isn't doing it, but that doesn't mean that there isn't some part of me that's negotiating that process. I shouldn't really be letting some random asshole on the internet dictate how I do things, but it just kind of rubbed me the wrong way, because even though, like, I can get these done pretty quickly, depending on... Ooh, shit, I like this. Oh, this is sexy. honestly, I sometimes fuck around with the placement a bit to see what I like best visually, but this is already looking pretty dope, so I'm probably not gonna fuck with it too much. Because it's got, like, these sort of horn-like looking things coming up there, and, sexy. Alright, so then let's do the symmetry part. Oh, fuck. No! That, when I'm a spaz sometimes and mash the mouse too much. And let's see, 9 points, 360 divided by 9 is 40. I've done a lot of 9-pointed sigils before, and... Ooh! I want these to line up a little better. Let's see. Play with bringing stuff closer or farther away. 40 degrees. Oh, but then that fucks up that one. I liked that that was a nice angle that came together there. Okay, there's a different issue I have with this, though. And that's that the center is a little bit too empty. 40. I'll bring it a little closer together. There's a lot of trial and error when it comes to doing the symmetry stuff. I kind of want those to, like, come together, if at all possible. That would look nice. Ooh, almost. Kind of getting there. Oh, not quite. Not quite. Yeah, maybe a couple of pixels closer. I use keyboard shortcuts a lot in this program. It makes my life a lot easier. Man, still not quite there. I'm just gonna give it 5 more pixels. Oh, shit, wait, I went too far? Really? Maybe 5 pixels in the other direction. I don't usually get quite this nitpicky, but now I'm a little bit self-conscious because I'm on camera. Alright, I'm gonna just kind of leave it, because that's not even... It's not just creating this rotated stuff, but then it's also picking the colors as well, since I've been doing a dual-colored approach here. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9... And then delete the... Oh, come on. Delete the extra bits that I don't want. Doop. Doop. Ooh, I kind of like this. I like that center bit. It looks kind of three-dimensional almost. Feel pretty good about this already. Alright, and then... Collapse it all to a single group, and apply the base color, And then the other color is yellow. I don't super feel like explaining my color choices right now, but I was kind of thinking like a skies and earth thing. You know, you think of yellow as like the sun or like kind of just light from above, right? And then brown is kind of like an earthy color. This is kind of like a, I don't know, clay-like brown, sort of silty, maybe. It's a good brown, I think, to be honest. Now, let's see. That's the part where I sort of decide what colors, or which letters to have which color. And I do it for aesthetic reasons, basically just what I find pleasing to my eye. But I find that my intuition about aesthetics is pretty decent, and as I've been allowing myself to trust it more, I've been... Oh, fuck, I missed one. Oh, no. Grab this fucking letter. I don't want you, silly cursive mem. Get back over there. You. I wanted you. Mr. Block Letter Pay. Come on. Oh, fuck. The reason I like to select all of them in a circle is because then I don't have to drag it up a bunch like I have to do right now because I fucked up. Alright, get, come on, get in the group. Okay. Yeah, and this kind of creates like a nice layered effect where, you know, you've got these other things that are the underneath color, which in this case is brown. And I also generally aim for connectivity. The top layer color, I generally like to basically create a path for it from the center all the way to the outside. I don't remember why I decided to do that, but I find that it works kind of nicely. Sometimes I violate this pattern for effect. Like, I did a Saturn sigil some time ago that kind of had a distinct group. Oh, fuck. Selected this, the wrong fucking letter again. It's a bit hard to select letters correctly when there's a lot of overlap going on. Oh, there we go. Alright. Let's see which colors I want. Oh, I think, I'm gonna want these hats. These are the letter chet, and these are from the word chida, which is means riddle. As I mentioned, the sigil says Baphomet is a riddle, which, again, really fucking apt for them, because enigmatic figure and trickster and all that fun stuff. And I guess there's also like different perspectives on who or what Baphomet is, and I would definitely be lying if I said I wasn't influenced by Raven Caldera's pagan takes on Baphomet. He has some really great essays in the book titled A Gift of Maggots. I really like that book. All right, let's see. Let's just take a break from doing the inside and just select the outside bits, because I want these to connect to the containing circle. I don't use the circle in my sigils as like a Solomonic, oh, like keep the dangerous spirit contained sort of thing. It's, to me, it's just kind of like a, you know, like a picture frame. Like, you have a picture in your frame, and having the frame accentuates the picture inside. It creates that boundary between what is the subject and what isn't, if that makes sense. So that's kind of how I use the circles. I also just like, I think circles with Hebrew lettering inside look really, really dope. So, as I mentioned, sometimes my decisions are driven by aesthetics, which I don't think is necessarily a bad thing. All right, let's see here. Now it's a matter of deciding what I want to have connected here. definitely gonna want these mems. Give me the mems. All your mems are belong to me. Yeah, in the past I used to just do single color sigils and they didn't look bad or anything, but they did start to kind of bore me after a while, and people also pointed out that they were a bit lacking in depth. I definitely like the duotone approach better. And I don't know what to say right now. I'm a bit lost for commentary. Okay, let's see. What connecting letters do I need? These guys would be nice to have. These are I'm trying to remember. For a second I thought these were shins, but Baphomet Chida doesn't have any shins. I'm actually at a loss for what this letter was supposed to be. It's not bet. Bet, I think, is that curly three looking thing. Or no, the curly three looking thing is a dalet. Process of elimination here. I could also cheat and refer back to the original text that I have hidden away as a separate layer, but ooh, that's coming together nicely. See, the thing now is I think I want these, because these will make a nice connecting line thingy. Grab the yod and the bet. Still can't remember what that funky letter is. I'm embarrassed. I don't know why I thought it was a shin. Is that all of them? I think so. Oh, it's probably pe. Yeah. If I were to take a guess, it's probably pe. That's silly, I should have fucking known that one. Oh, there's some sneaky little vobs in here. Oh, see, if I take the vob, then I have to get the... I don't want to color everything in the, like, I want there to be some kind of contrast still between the colors, but I also really like connectivity in these, so I'm, like, kind of at a loss here as to what I should do. I mean, if I added this and the valves, that would add that connectivity that I want, and it wouldn't really break things. Another thing I like to do is sort of sometimes peek at the remaining underlayer. Sometimes I do end up mostly coloring in the primary color, but I kind of want these dalets. Let's get the dalets. I think these would look good. No, fuck. Select. I apologize. My commentary has been lacking. I'm feeling extra ADHD today. I'm not diagnosed, but I have some suspicions. Let's just put it that way. Man. Could probably leave those spokes alone. Maybe. You know what? What happens if I get these? And then leave the other ones. I think that's what I'll do. These hays look a little bit awkward. One of the maybe not ideal aspects of this sigil, but maybe if I color them yellow, they will look a little bit more interesting. Ooh, okay, alright, that's not too bad. Oh, but then they have that derpy looking overlap. Ugh. Maybe I'll do the other thing. I'm feeling that desire for connectivity. I want this thing to be a nice, strongly connected thing. I'm hoping that if I do these ones and then just leave it at that, it won't look too heavily lopsided in favor of in favor of the yellow. I don't want the solar to completely overpower things. And, you know, if this doesn't turn out my best sigil ever, it's not the end of the world. I make a lot of these, and... Well, then this will just give ammunition to my critics. Heh, I don't think I can win. Not that I should really care about that, but... Well... As much as I try to pretend I don't care what other people think, I actually do oftentimes care what other people think. Okay, alright, that doesn't look too bad. Actually, it gives it like a nice sort of curly looking circle around it. And then there's still a little bit of an underlayer, especially the spokes, kind of give it a bit of additional flavor there. I feel pretty decent about this, actually. And now we do the final bit where we group them together and then scale them to fit inside the circle. Also, I tend to use 1307 a lot as my sizing thingy. Fun fact about 1307, it is a year that is of historical relevance to the Baphomet Templar story. Which is kind of fun. I think that's the year, there was like probably some big trial or something that year. I don't quite remember. But it's a year with historical associations. The other reason I like 1307 is, well, A, my online handle that I use everywhere is lbds137. It's got 1, 3, and 7 in there. And also the gematria of the spelling of Baphomet with the tet is 137. And I also like 137 because those numbers add up to 11, which is the number of Kikpot. And I am a little bit edgy at times, and I disagree with current 218 and their brand of anti-cosmic Satanism, but I do like the number 218. I think it's a nice number. And as I discovered, 218 is not just the sum of their weird egregore Azerate, but it also has a much simpler derivation. 218 is Yareach in Hebrew, which means moon, and so I see 218 as kind of a lunar number, and I use 21.8 degrees as a rotation factor in my sigils, which works pretty well, and yeah, I think it's a nice number, and even if I don't really agree with the Chuggle fucks who use it heavily in their cosmology, I can still sort of take the bits and pieces that I like, or that I find useful, and take them and run with them. So, anyway, I'm rambling a lot, and this video probably got too long, but here's a sigil, and I feel pretty good about it, so yeah. Thanks for watching, and I'll upload this to my YouTube and add it to the playlist with my other 4 sigil videos now. Anyway, I was way overdue for one of these, so there you are. Enjoy your Sunday, and this is the conclusion of this video.